What is good, friends? We are back with more World Cup action, and today, hopefully, my narration will be fine because I got that young sleep in. And yeah, we have Axeltan from Team Spain versus Obliviate from Team Germany. So yeah, obviously rooting for Germany. So let me change this over here because I'm German. Gotta do that. Suicune Mega Manectric Balance versus some weird semi-stall. I know that Blunder used the Axel 10 team and had a Zard X, but on this team I still think it's gonna be Zard Y. Like, I just see Zard Y always paired with Dougie. This is a nasty as fuck game. Let me see if Obliviate can break. I'm wondering if it's Karma and Clef. I think it's Karma and Clef. Suicune can win this if it's not. I mean, unaware Clef, not Karma. Did I say? This is unaware Clef, I assume. Does Suicune just win if it's not unaware Clef? They don't really run Karma. They run Wish Protect, Heal Bell, Moonblast. Like, it makes sense on this, like, semi-stall type of team. Like, this is basically stall. The only difference is that you have a Zard over a Sableye. And then there's a few different mons. Like, usually you don't see Mew and Celesteela on these fatter builds. I mean, you still obviously see Celesteela on fat balance. But, like, this is really semi-stall-ish. Like, it's obviously gonna be default Mew. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, like, this Latias has to be Choice Scarf. I legit said it was Auras. No, it's not Auras. I mean, he has a Celesteela. But yeah, yesterday I thought that too, when one guy only had a Magearnaut, everything else was Auras. Yeah, this is kind of tough turn for Obliviate, because if you predict the Clefable, you go for Trick here. Because I don't think he needs a Scarf in this game. Like, if he breaks the Celesteela slash Clef, he can go for Trick. But the thing is, Zard Y can take any hit and just Roost. Unless it's Z-Thunder Lardy, Zard Y can probably live a hit and Roost it off. Like, especially if he goes for Draco. Because then it will be at minus 2. And Zardwell were putting so much work with Obliv. Let me just call him that. Because I'm not sure if it. Yeah, he doesn't Mega Evolve, so he's a bulky Zard. He doesn't want to show if he's X or Y. But yeah, like I said, Roost there was a potential nice play. It covers the Trick play and it covers whatever he goes for, because he probably don't die. So maybe he's Zard X because he didn't Mega. Pretty sure he has some HP investment for sure. Yeah, now he can go into his. No, if he's Zard X, he can Mega Evolve here easily. I'm wondering if he's able with Zard X. I mean, I was going off Zard Y the entire time, but I'm not sure. Like, him not Mega Evolving kind of makes me think that he could be Zard X because of the Draco. It would be super effective otherwise, but it still could be Zard Y. And he just didn't want a Mega to, like, not give out information. So he goes into Alamomola. And Obliviate doesn't have. Yeah, Obliviate is gonna go Clefable and a Toxic here. He goes Suicune. So this probably confirms. Oh, he has Knockoff. That's a good play. I think the Suicune has Rest, because otherwise he would not let get. He either has Rest on this or he has Healable support, because otherwise he would never let this get poisoned or Scald burned. Like, if it's a sub Protect Kun, you would never make this play, I don't think. A threat gone. Your leftovers are really huge on Suicune. Yeah, this is. Yeah, it has Toxic, but like a knockoff Toxic Wish Protect, I assume. Yeah, this has to be Rest for sure. And yeah, like I said earlier, if this is not. If this is not unaware cleft, this coon is gonna go in. This coon is gonna put in so much work, like even without leftovers. The thing is, if he's rest without sleep talk, and the doggy has a Z move and screech, the doggy can actually break the coon. Cause on the turn, this goes for rest. And like on the turn after this goes for rest, and he finds out if he just has sleep talk, like. He can has to scout a while, Exelton has to scout a while to figure out this entire moveset. And if he finds out, oh, it's substitute rest. I think it's substitute rest. He was talking about Flokun. It's sub rest, but I'm not gonna say anything in the chat. I think it's sub rest. Because he was talking about that set. Sub rest Calmind Scald, exactly. Flokun, yup. I've heard about that earlier. Like, obviously, he obviously had rest if he went for sub. And if he brought this in on Almola. But yeah, what I was saying earlier. Now he knows this doesn't have sleep talk. Like, he basically already knows the set because the last move is obviously Scald. And yeah. Now you notice this has to sleep for two turns. But he has to get rid of the sub first. So he's Rocks Clef, which kind of makes me think that he's not unaware Clef. So this Kun actually put in. This coon can actually put in a lot of work, but yeah, he goes into the doggy, that's what I'm talking about. Now he can break the sub, the coon sleeps one more turn, but now he's forced out, the Scald is... Now, if I'm Obliv, I think I'm just gonna comment again here. Like, if he has Screech plus Z-move, he has to bring this in on the right turn. Like, after Suicune burned one sleep turn, he can bring doggy in, then go for Screech and then kill it with Z-move. Yeah, he goes for Scald, which is the safe play. But I think that was pretty obvious that Exelton would switch out to PP stall a Scald there. So I definitely would have just Calm-Minded or subbed again. So this is really annoying now, but he's gonna sub up here. I mean, this Kuhn is still gonna put in some work, but I can see what Exelton is doing already. He's trying to stall out the Scald PP, obviously. I mean, it's still fine for Oblivious, some Scalds, 23. But Almola has Wish and it's just annoying. Like, you have to Calm-Mind up before you do any damage to this, obviously. And even then, burn got nerfed, and like, if it can avoid the burn, or if he plays it correct, he might be able to stall this out of Scalds, yeah. He might lose like one Pokemon in the process, we'll see. League says Alo wins. Yeah, you obviously Calm-Mind up again, and eventually you're gonna sub. No, I think you can just spam Calm-Mind for now. Like, you already lost your leftover, so it's not like you. This Clef, if it has knockoff, can do anything to you. But yeah, pressure coming through here, wasting two Moonblast PP. Yeah, his Ladi's probably gonna have Defog, because he would be a bit weak to opposing Spike Stag. As two Moonblasts don't even break the sub. Oh my lord. Yeah. Yeah, this is really cool. You can PP stall this the way you do other Suicunes. Because other Suicunes, you just leave them at full so they can't rest. But this one can sub up and then rest. That's really cool. But sometimes I like Sleep Talk in the sense that you get extra Scald PP out of your Suicune. I don't know why he doesn't go to plus 6. I don't think I would Scald at plus 3, that doesn't do enough. I guess he's trying to see if it's unaware Clef. I don't think it would I don't think that's unaware Clef that did 52. We will calc this real quick. And yeah, I assume he's just gonna sub or Calm-Mind. And Exel is gonna go Alamomola. Exel is gonna softball here, yeah. Unless he's Wish Protect, but I think he's not. Semi softball, a Magic Guard at this point. Clefable. Yes, yeah, Scald at plus 3. There's 54 to 64 and 52. So this Clefable does have a little bit. This Clefable does have a little bit Spadef. So because I was calculating versus Fistef Clefable, but he's definitely not unaware. So we figure that out for now. So if he goes to plus 6, this Kuhn is gonna be a pain for Axel, but yeah, he has Alma Molar. And how much is plus 6 gonna do to Clefable, by the way? he has some spadev, like, I don't know how many spadev he has, but it's gonna do around 80 or 90%, yeah. Scale from 1 to sub rest week, and how triggered are you? But he just comments again here, right? Like, you obviously don't want to waste more skull PP. Yeah, I think he already made this play. Never mind. Oblivious timer is also ticking. But access timer is way lower already. From earlier turns where he was taking time. Yeah, you can already tell we're gonna be here for a while. Probably like at least a 30 minute game, maybe a 40 minute game. I mean, you guys obviously see the video length when I upload this. I mean, I assume Axel is just gonna go into Alma Mola here. Yeah, this is kinda tough for Axel. I'm not really sure what I would do. Like, does he even have good counterplay? He has to hope that his Alma Mola is able to stall us out of skulls. So he can ban when? He just Moonblast, it doesn't break the sub, so like he basically wasted another 2 PP. Yeah, I don't think that was the play, but like, I also don't know what the right play, like what I would do in this scenario. Like, you just have to hope that the Coon doesn't break your team, because like, you can't really do much back to the Coon. Especially if it has a sub up, you can't just go hard into Dougie and break it. With Screech into Z-move or Screech into EQ in general. Yeah, it's not unaware, since he has softball, it's also not unaware from the damage that he did earlier, that's why I called. Yeah, I think Nintendo should be playing soon, hopefully no more games at the same time today. Yesterday, there were like 3 games, the PDC game like took so long that I had to record 2 other games in the same video. I uploaded that earlier. Oh yeah, and I did miss Googly versus Gondra. That was Oceania versus Latin America. They played 4 AM my time, so, and I finally went to sleep after like 30 hours of being up and catching so many World Cup games for you guys. Yeah, I will leave a link to that replay in the description down below, so you guys can check that out if you missed it. It was an okay game, but I didn't really feel like recording it because like there's so many games that I want to live record today, and I obviously can't catch every game. There's so many games in World Cup. So he rested up. Dougie can earthquake and break the sub, and I assume after he breaks the sub, this is gonna wake up now, so I assume you can just sub again here, right? This is really ingenious, because they have to break the sub and they always waste 2 PP. I love pressure. I mean, I assume that was not the play, dude. Because he's trying to stall you out of skull. It's so obvious that he's doing that. I know that you have to be careful with the duck tree, because if the duck tree goes for Screech into Z-move, you would have gotten blown away. So I can understand this play in that sense. But on the other side, it was kind of obvious. And that did absolutely nothing. So it was 33%. So how much will it do at plus 6? That was plus 4, right? So yeah, I think he's somewhere around this, along those lines, the Alma Mola bet. So it is 42 to 50. So he's probably gonna be able to stall out this Coon. But the thing is, Alma Mola is gonna lose a lot of PP in the process, and we'll see if he has enough PP. I mean, Knockoff has like 15 PP if you count pressure, and Toxic has like Knockoff has 15 left, Toxic has 7 left, but Wish obviously has 16 because Wish is on your side, so it doesn't get affected by pressure. Pressure only affects moves that go like that attack you, like that, or like defog or stealth fog that go on your side of the field. I'm not that good at explaining it, but yeah, he's gonna go Clef, and now he's just gonna go back into Alma Mola basically. But he can also click rocks once, it doesn't really matter. But I think he's just gonna go back into Alo, and he's gonna come into plus 6. Why is he scalding? I don't get it. And thankfully, I mean, yeah, it worked out here because he got the burn, but I mean, maybe he bricked the Clef to stay and I can get that, but like, it was pretty obvious that he was just going back into Alamomola. But the thing is, the Scald just cancelled, the burn just cancelled out the leftovers. So it's not like the Alamomola loses that much health. And the Axel is just gonna go back to Aloe here. Like, this is pretty simple. Like, not much to think about. I don't know why he's taking so long. I don't think Axel's team will have Heal Bell support unless the last move on his Clef is Heal Bell. But if his Mew Aloe gets poisoned, that would be really annoying for his team, like, in general. Just comments again, doesn't want to waste the Scald BP, which is kind of smart. But eventually he has to waste Scald. So Axel is either gonna go for a Wish here. Yeah, I think he's gonna go for a Wish. I can be quick, Ben, Ductio, Sableye, and Zuhu, and please not. I mean, I hit a Ductio in Arena Trap. I really wished I would have gone banned. I don't know about Sableye at the moment. Stall would be pretty easy to beat if they got rid of the Dougie, because the Dougie just helps Stall to get rid of certain stall breakers. But yeah, stall is like, if the stall, the well played stall is generally deadly, and I'm not gonna lie. Like, in Auras, stall is pretty beatable, I feel. Like, it's still good, but it's pretty beatable after the bend. Yeah, he went for knockoff first and then for Wish, so he's either gonna go for Protect here, he's probably gonna comment predicting a Protect or Switch out or something. He can go into Clefable here. But Wish, Protect is probably the better play because, yeah, he needs this healthy so he can lift two Scalds. Because if he would Switch out, he would get Regenerator, but he would still be in range for two Scalds, so he doesn't want to risk that, which makes a lot of sense. And yeah, now he's gonna knock off a Wish again. Hype is over, how does it even break Aloe? I mean, he just needs Axel to go for knockoff on a turn that he goes for Scald. And if he gets a crit or a high roll, he can potentially 2-hit KO. Now he probably needs a crit to 2-hit KO, I don't think high roll. Yeah, I think the highest damage he can do is like 50. Yeah, 46, that was a little bit higher than the 42. Yeah, so he needs Axel to not protect D and get a high roll. But I'm pretty sure Axel is gonna protect. I mean, yeah, this Deadl is obviously still going quicker than PTC's. That game was, oh, good lord. Yeah, he comments making the protect, nice play. Yeah, if he crits one of his Scalds, he might be able to get one kill. The thing is, once he's out of Scalds, it's pretty much over. That's what I was saying earlier, I like Sleep Talk for extra Scald BP, but I don't think Sleep Talk would either win. Like, I don't think the standard Krokun set would win this game. Like, so if I was Obliviate, how could he have, like, built this team different to like, add something that lures in at Alamomola? I mean, if he had rest on this Kuhn and he got the Alamomola on the correct turn and Axel doesn't have Heal Bell, this game would have been over. But yeah, the sub is nice in a sense that it helps you when you're asleep so that the Dougie doesn't screech into EQ or Z move you. But I could see Toxic would have put in a lot of work here if he gets the Aloe. I mean, he obviously went for the Scald burn because he didn't have Toxic. And he has Heal Bell, so that answers my question. Even if he had Toxic, it would not have been game over because he has Heal Bell on. He has Heal Bell on the Magic Guard Clefable. But I mean, like I said, his team really appreciates Heal Bell support. So he uses that to get rid of the burn, and there's no new burn, so yeah, Axel 10 is probably gonna stall this out successfully. The thing is, he just needs the crit. He just needs to Scald here, have him not protect and get the crit, and then the game is probably over. But yeah, if no crits happen, this is in Axel 10's favor that the Kuhn doesn't do anything. He goes back into Mew, which was a bit risky, but he called Mighty predicting a protect. Scalding, that would have been nice. I don't know if he was trying to get this Mew burned, so they could synchronize. I think synchronize works through substitute, right? So the Kun would have gotten burned too. I think that's how it works, and then he was kind of forced to rest up eventually. But I don't think it matters if the Kun is forced to rest. If it's out of Scald, it's useless anyway. So he stays in with the Mew here. I don't know why, but he roosts, okay. Because if he went for anything else that it was not roost, I was about to say, why did he stay in? But yeah. Like, this is gonna be running out, like, this is gonna be out of Scald. He's forced out here. The aloe is at 93, so this is actually kind of tough. If he gets two good rolls, or if he gets the burn here on the incoming aloe, this is kind of tough for Axel. I don't think I would have switched the aloe out, like, what? So, do we see Hyrule? Not really. Ah, man. So now, it's still the same position. If he just gets a Scald off, assume X is gonna protect, exactly. And he tried to, he Scald. I thought he would've called Mighty there, because the protect was obvious this time. Last time he didn't go for it, kind of luring him into wasting a Scald here, and this time he went for it. But that was well played by Axel, I guess. But yeah, like I said, still crit can kill this. So it's a 6.25% chance that the game ends. See how much... No burn though, man. That was really close, yeah. I don't think I would have ever switched out this. I would have always wished teched it. Okay, so this time he comments, predicting that, so he doesn't waste Scald. I mean, Axel can't really switch into anything. I mean, he can switch into Clef once. Actually, he can't. Clef will take like 80 or something. I mean, he can, but like, it would be really annoying. Please just get a burn for something. Ah, yeah, this is not looking good. I mean, he's still in range to die from crit, obviously, but he's just gonna protect here. There's no way you do anything other than protect, even if you know that Obliviate will just comment on something else. Like, Obliviate will not Scald here, but you never risk this. Yeah, if you're in range from a Scald, you obviously don't risk it. But yeah, he comments. Just what he had to do, and now he's gonna Scald again. He only has 12 left. So if this aloe Scalds, if this stalls out a few more, and even if it gets crit, if the Kun has like no Scalds left, the rest of the team obviously walls it. Yeah, he really needs to get a burn or a crit. A crit burn would be optimal. But yeah. Let's see, there's the crit, and the burn. Didn't I call it? I just said a crit burn would be optimal. There we go. There we go. I mean, he's obviously gonna protect here. Yeah, obviously it's not the perfect time to crit, he was not in range. But it's still better than nothing, right? Command again, okay. So, he's just gonna Scald here. He only has 10 left after this. Yeah, if he crits another one, this game is over, but... Like, he has to crit this specific turn. Yeah, second crit just wins, that's what I'm saying. I mean, if he's that Y, even if he crits here, some of the other Pokemon might be able to take his Scald better. But yeah, at this point, if he crits here, it's over. Like, no doubt in my mind. But he just got a 6.26% chance to get a crit, so I don't think he's gonna get it again. 6.25% is the chance, right? Pretty unlikely to get it again. Like, just two turns right after. But he only has a few Scalds left, so, like, he has to crit, like, in his next 3 or 4 Scalds, I think. Because he needs enough PP to, like, run through the rest of the team. Nah, actually, if he crits this when he has, like, 3 Scalds left... Nah, if he has crits with 3 Scalds left, I don't think he's gonna get 1 kill max if he comes out here with 3 Scalds. Cause the Clefable is gonna soft bolt spam and gonna get 2 hit KO'd only, then he only has 1 Scald left. And if the Duggy is sashed, it's gonna waste the last Scald. I mean, it just depends when he can get another crit. I mean, obviously if he doesn't get it, this is gonna be... This Kun is not gonna be winning. I don't know if rest was the play. Because now the Ala goes back to full. Yeah, I don't know why. Yeah, maybe I said that didn't help. Because he was in range to dive him a crit there. Now he's just gonna go back to full. Axelton is just gonna switch around to not waste any PP. He's gonna go into his Mew here to wish that up the back to full. Because he knows this is gonna be asleep. You can go into Mew or into Dougie, but I assume Mew he wants that at full. I'm not really sure, man. Yeah, he just wishes that up. I'm not really sure about that rest play. I mean, obviously, if he didn't get a crit, Kun wasn't winning, but, like, why not go for it there? Like, if you get super high rolls and stuff. Now the Allo's back at full, and he's gonna go for another wish here, I assume. He only has 11 skulls, and Wish still has 9 PP, so this is gonna be rough. What is Oblivion's other win con? If he's double Calm Mind, if he's Calm Mind kill Fable. Yeah, he's Calm Minding me, but that doesn't... I mean, he wastes knock off PP. I would just Calm Mind again. Because he's gonna wish on this turn. And if you can waste his wishes without wasting Scald, that's actually a nice play, yeah. If Oblivion's Clefable is Calm Mind, maybe it can win. But I assume his Clefable is gonna be Starfox to get up Rocks versus Sableye. Because if he gets up Rocks versus Sableye, this Suicune can also be really annoying for Stall. I don't think it wins, but it can be annoying. He switches out and we see he's not unaware. He loses his leftovers. I'm not sure. I think he could have stayed in a bit more. Stall out a lot of knockoff PP. I mean, he wasn't really gaining anything with the Kun in there. But yeah. I mean, nothing stops CM Clef. What stops CM Clef? I guess it's a heavy slam cell stealer kind of stops it. I mean, he could be Rocks CM, but I think he's gonna be Rocks Flamethrower or Rocks Knockoff. Remember when people were saying Axel should forfeit and that Suicune won? I mean, it did win if you just get the crit on the correct turn, but he didn't go for it. I mean, it's understandable that he doesn't want to waste all the Skull PP. He's just gonna want to sell Steeler, right? Oh, he's got his Nazard. Yeah, that's the Rocks, that was pretty obvious. Because I assume this Ferrothorn is gonna have Spikes, Lead Seed, and then two attacking moves. And Rocks on Clef, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So maybe he doesn't even have Defog on Ladi. Because he doesn't have anything that weak to hazards, but... I mean, Spike's deck would still be a bit annoying. Even though Spikes only hit 3 of his mons. Goes Hard Ladi on a Flare Blitz. I mean, that was a nice play overall. Because it covers the Flare Blitz play from Zardex, and it covers the... Zardwai going for... Like, Zardwai basically can't touch this. Was that way, unless it's the Red Dragon Pulse set. I mean, it's not that it can't touch it. If it's Scarf Ladi and doesn't have roosts, it's obviously gonna get weakened even by that way. But yeah, Axel is gonna be tempted to go into Mew here and try to defog. Yeah. So does he go for trick? Oh my lord, nice play. Yeah, so it was Zardex. I wasn't wrong. Like, I thought it was that way first, but then when he didn't Mega, I thought it could be Zardex, yeah. I mean, so now it's over, still Zard sets up, so I think this might be the wrong play in the chat. Crippling Mew is really nice. I mean, I'm not sure if the Zard is gonna be DD, it could be. Like, I know that Woolworth Zard is not the best at the moment, but stuff like Tapu Fini, but Tapu Fini is not that common. Like, I could still see the Zard being, like, I think this is a bulkier Zard. I don't know if it's Bulky Dragon Dance. That's the question here. I think it's just could be Will-O-Wisp. Just gotta check real quick of this game that I uploaded if it's public. Okay, it's not public because I didn't name it yet. I still have two more games from yesterday to upload. I actually recorded. I actually have three more, but a few games moderation was bad, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna upload them because I was really tired. I was like 30 hours up. But yeah, let's not talk about that today. Here's Comet Rocks, wow. So this Clefable is gonna put in the work for Obliv. Cause like I was thinking it could be double heal, but like a double Calm Mind. But yeah, this puts in some work, but it's not like it wins. Like Heal Bell Starfrog is cool in a semi-stall team. Why is it CM Starfrog? Goes into a Coon predicting the Heavy Slam. And Exeltan makes a gold play. Predicts the switch, goes for lead seed. Yeah, that was a really nice play on Axel's part. I mean, you already know that he didn't lose anything for making that play. Because if the Clefable stays in, what is it gonna do? It only has Moonblast to touch you. If it comments again, you can still attack him the next turn, but if he Moonblasts it, it does absolutely nothing. And he, oh my lord, he keeps out playing. He goes for Flamethrower. I assume this is gonna be like Trouble Berry or something. I don't think Zemo Ferrothorn is a thing. The motherfucking sheriff. Okay, I shouldn't have pronounced that word. That was not the right of me. Protect, wow. So he has. Ether doesn't have spikes. Oh, he has lead seed, protect, spikes, and only one attacking move. They started another game. I just want to find out if it's World Cup real quick. Oh, wait, this was a random battle. I didn't mean to click on this. Hello? Goes for lead seed again. He's an Obliviate head. That boy's getting played. I have to dip, but I want to watch this. I mean, I get that you want to watch it live, but yeah, you already know I'm uploading this. Like, sometimes it gets me really mad when people say I have to leave, but I want to watch this. Like, just watch my YouTube. I mean, I can understand it, because it's Obliviate's teammate, and he obviously wants to see him live play. Because when I upload it, it's a few hours later, and the game is already kind of outdated. The only reason it's outdated at the moment is because, like, this game will go up, like, maybe 5 or 6 hours after. Maybe even later, after it happened. Get in the Dougie on the rest, and yeah, now the Coon is dead because he gets that crit. Actually, I don't think the crit matters. Yeah, he would've... That crit didn't matter, he just outplayed him there. That Dougie play was really nice, yeah. Because the Coon was seated. He would've been asleep one more time, yeah. One more turn, pretty sure the crit didn't matter. Without a crit, it would've done... Yeah, it would've done over 30. Yep, think it would have 2 hit KO'd still. With the combination of lefties being knocked off and this Coon being seated, still should have 2 hit KO'd. So yeah, this is really in Exultant's favor. The Coon is gone. The Clefable is not gonna do much as long as the Steeler is around. So the only way Obliviate can come back is if his Landorus like weakens Exult's team to the point where Clef can put him work. So he's SD, this Mew is a Choice Scarf trick, so if the Mew is Ice Beam... Which I don't think it has Ice Beam because he has Alamomola and Clef to check Zygarde. I think it would be Will-O-Wisp, Bruised, Defog, and then Psychic on... Psychic or Volt Switch? I think Psychic. Dude, he doesn't have Ice Beam Padlob. Are you bad? Look at his team structure. Oh, he does have Ice Beam, holy shit! Okay, now I look like a young noob. I called Padlock bad and... Because I said it's obviously that... Obviously he doesn't have Ice Beam, but he has Ice Beam. I mean, that makes sense. In the sense that... that helps him... check offensive Landorus. Like, fast Landorus would substitute with setup on Will-O-Wisp Mew. But he still has... Like, he has Celesteela and Alamomola, which can also help. But if they get overwhelmed by another physical, like other members that they have to check, I can see why he would have Ice Beam, but I really thought he had Psychic on this team, but I guess I'm wrong. And he doubles into Dougie on the Manectric. Somebody stop this man. So he's just gonna go for HP Ice here. Scarf Duck Trio fails to kill Manectric. He goes for Overheat and he lives on one. Oh, it's Overheat. Overheat is stronger than HP Ice, right? Data Overheat. Yeah, Overheat is a little bit stronger and it still didn't kill. So this Dougie probably has some HP investment, or it was just a low roll. EV to live. Yeah, this game should be over. I love how I thought that the Mew wasn't Ice Beam, like I was really sure, and then it was Ice Beam. Yeah, if Oblivion stayed in with his cool and got the crit on the aloe on a specific turn earlier where it wasn't Scald good range, he could have easily won it, but I mean he had to rely on a crit, so there's that. I don't think he would have gotten it. He already got one crit earlier. Dugtrio stays being Dugtrio. No, Celesteela just wins. I mean, yeah, that's true. The Lati can't even cripple the Celesteela with Trick because it already has leftovers. And Trick that Scarf away. Yeah, Landorus still gets checked by Scarf. That Mew that got a Scarf Trick in the Aloe. And Celesteela. Yeah, Celesteela should win on its own. And that's the. I mean, if this is as. It showed SD, so I assume it's SDZ move. I think Axel has to switch out because if this is sub SD and he stays in with a Dougie locked into Earthquake, he can potentially lose to this subbing and SDing up, yeah. So he's probably gonna go either Hard Celesteela or Hard Mew. Celesteela, Mew or Aloe Momola, but I assume either Mew or Celesteela is gonna be coming out. Cause Aloe Momola only has Toxic Knockoff, it doesn't have Scald, so if this has sub, Aloe Momola can't touch this. So yeah, Mew or Celesteela is the play, I feel. I think, yep. Reaxel 10 is gonna pick up the win for Team Spain, probably. But I should actually be really careful with saying new things. Yesterday, there was like one or two games where I thought one person won and they turned it around. But unless Axel 10 messes up, he has this game. Like, I think he has to choke to lose at this point. I mean, Rock Polish won't do anything. Other than helping him outspeed the Mew. He goes for SD, which is nice. Yeah, Rock Polish would have been to outspeed the Mew, I guess, yeah. But he's gonna spam Heavy Slam here, not giving this a free substitute. And Continental Crusher plus 2 if the Celesteela is Spadef. Would that even kill? Rockium. Celesteela, you Spadef. Let's say plus 2. This is Element Lando, by the way. I'm just calling Element because we're going off. We want to see the max potential damage. Yeah, Element would kill at plus 2. But he's sub and he goes for Leech Seed. Exactly, I would have never gone for Leech Seed, like I said. He is really that's the reason why you don't go Almola, because if this is sub, your Knockoff and Toxic can't do anything to this. But yeah, that was. If he really has Continental Crush and he picks off the Celesteela here, Obliviate is still in this game. Who says it's over for who? Sub is better for Axel than Rock Polish. He still loses Padlock. Let me see. If he has Continental Crush, I mean, if the Celesteela is Fist Death, that obviously lives. But I'm going off the Celesteela being Spadef. Yeah, the Celesteela has to be Spadef for stuff like Tapu Lele. Like Almamola, and I assume his Clef is gonna be more Fist Def. His Aloe was like mixed defensive, but more Fist Def, I assume. Even though I calc Spadef Aloe earlier in the calc, like, Even with Fist Death and like a little bit more HP than the split that I had in the calc, I still think this could be. He only has. He didn't want to waste the Z move, or he predicted Protect. Did he predict Protect there? Predict set one and he saved the Z move? Or did he predict Protect? I think he should have just SD'd again. Does he not have a Z move? Maybe he's Z Earthquake? But yeah, the Mew. Yeah, the, pretty much the Mew still outspeeds this after the sub gets broken. Like, the Mew can kill this after the sub is broken, so what I'm trying to say with a choice Scarf Ice Beam, because I get a Scarf trick. The Mew should outspeed this, right? And if the Zard is a bulky set that doesn't outspeed this Landorus, and he could have kept the sub up and killed us with Continental Crush, and he had Ground Z to kill. Like, nah, Alamomola was set up for that anyway. Yeah, he could have. I think he could have won this game if he had crushed to Oko this. No, he's not. He's just gonna Heavy Slam, dude. He's not gonna give you a sub. Like, he's not gonna make the same mistake again, obviously. I mean, I guess he, that's his only play, right? Banking on the opponent misplaying. I mean, it was well played overall by Axel 10. I just don't know if I would have made that leech hit play, but it works. He has this game now. I mean, he played like a god earlier, so nothing I can say. I guess he deserved, yeah, he deserves this one for sure. I think White King said he's gonna play all three games today, but I don't know if I can trust that or if he's trolling. Yeah, I believe just banking on him going for lead seat, but it doesn't work, and yeah, this game's over. So he's forced to Stone Edge here. Does he not have the Z move? I think he wanted to save the Z move to Oko's specific one, I'm not sure. Yeah, and he goes Dougie on a Z move. Oh my lord, the flex. He's gonna go into Mew, Mew out speed. He's gonna go for Ice Beam here. Yeah, if he crushed earlier, the Celestia would have died from full. Or maybe he's Jolly Landorus. I killed Adamant. Maybe he's Jolly Landorus. Goes into Clef on the Ice Beam, but this just gives Axel a free Celestia switch. Now even Jolly kills. So I'm really not sure why he really had to have predicted Protect. But if you predict Protect, don't you SD again? I don't really understand. I mean, I think Axel probably still would have won, but could have been come down really close if the Celestia died to Crush. Call him the Crush. But yeah, if the Lander. Like, if the Lander had a sub up and the Celestia died, he could have put in so much work. It depends, obviously, if the Zard has something to outspeed the Lander. But if the Zard does not speed the Lander. Like, if the Zard has enough speed, is what I'm trying to say. He sacks up his Pharaoh with a combination of Heavy Slam and Flamethrower. So he's just gonna protect it to get more leftovers. Ladi can't do anything. I think he can just forfeit. Landorus dies to rocks, Clefable loses to this, everything loses to this, yep, GG. And yeah, it sucks because I was rooting for Team Germany, you guys know. But yeah, Spain takes the win. Congrats to Axel 10, I think that was his first game, right? Not 100% sure. But yeah. I think Germany is 4-3 after this game. Anyone seen a beat on this brutal? I mean, Gondra. Like I said, I believe Gondra's replay in the description. Gondra has been putting in work so far, like, he has been putting in beatdowns. But I guess the first game where he used Majuna was just a good matchup for Majuna. GG, you played extremely well, yeah. The only play I wouldn't have made is leech seeding on a potential sub Landorus, but on the other side, I wouldn't have made some of these godly plays that he made before that, so. Hard matchup for who? For Axel? I mean, yeah, Zuko was annoying, but like, it didn't break his team. If he didn't have Al, he would have lost, obviously, but like. Yeah, I don't know why. I mean, he's still playing it out. I don't know. I guess that's. He doesn't want to give up, but yeah, Landorus dies to rocks. And Axel 10 picks up the win for Spain, and I thank you guys for watching, and we will be back with more World Cup coverage later, and Dockridge signing out. Peace.